No.
Today. I've run out of sleep.
No, because we weren't here last
week. We weren't here last time, okay.
Can only remember from morning to
yes.
morning.
So just find some space.
Well,
have your feet shoulder width apart.
Oh,
this is fantastic. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 on Zoom. It's fantastic. And I've got two people missing on Zoom, so I normally have four. So I'm very happy. Okay, so Happy New Year, everybody. Actually, I will put... I better go on Zoom. I've got some music on my phone. I worked out how to do that. Okay, if we use the music.
I like it with the music.
You like it with the music?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'll put that over there. So nice and relaxed. And what we're going to do, because this is the first one back, we're going to ease ourselves in. So just sink the hips back and down. Lengthen through the spine. Take a few slow, deep breaths. So we'll look at some of the silk reeling exercises and a little bit on the form, but not too much. Just ease people in. So just very gently. So those of you on Zoom, I'm having to use my older laptop because my other laptop is still getting mended. It's turned into a bit of a kind of waiting for Godot type. So this thing's really slow, so I might try having to use my phone for the Zoom. Keep breathing. So just notice the feeling of contact with the feet and the ground. Sink your hips back and down. Soften the knees and the ankles. And just have the head floating and you want your chin tucked in. So tuck the chin in. And we're looking forwards, listening behind and above. This is good. Yeah, do feel free to. So, how on earth did you find out with your new people about the class? Oh, you did the recruitment. I should be paying you commission then. Fantastic. Thanks for that. Yeah, do feel free to let your friends know about this class. And the other thing is, I bought a special machine that takes card payments for people that don't do cash.
Ooh.
And I bought it. The only thing is I've got to add a 50 pence on because they charge me loads of money for the privilege of, you know, so, but I will try and work out how to work this stupid machine at the weekend because I...
Well, you'll be all right in here, but last year for the Reach Fair, they got them for the car park.
Yeah.
And of course, there's no Wi-Fi in the car park.
So I just thought I'd get a bit modernised, but it'll have to be, if you want to pay by card, it'll have to be £5.50, otherwise I'll get a lot less. I get charged, yeah. They charge a monthly fee and they also charge per transaction. So it's a bit of a... But you get lots of support.
Yeah.
Like, how do I switch it on again and that kind of thing. So they're very good. But I thought I'd better get a bit more modern, you know.
I'm actually going to open an online banking account.
Oh, well done. Yeah. Yeah, I've conditioning exercises today because we do have a few new people and I don't want to overload with too much stuff. So nice and relaxed. Relax around the jaw. Nice and tall. So, yeah, well, I've opened the door because of the ventilation thingy, because we're still, you know, even though we've all been jabbed and things, we're still doing the ventilation. So. But it's quite a nice day. I mean, we could have almost gone outside, but no,
it's too chilly.
Too chilly. I couldn't just, oh.
It's nice to look at. You can see the trick.
Just relax. So your muscles, think of them softening and think of an upward feeling in your bones. Yeah, because if everybody brought an extra person, then that would be brilliant. We'd have to fill those spaces as well. So it's okay, it's not. It then looks like I wasn't just teaching an empty room. I've done that before at Swaff and Pryor when I've basically been like Billy Nomades on Zoom, you know. So it's quite bad. So the Zoom thing is an after effect of the pandemic in that I spent nearly 2 years on Zoom. And then, you know, all dotted all over the country. So I've got some people and they still want to come on Zoom and I'm happy to have the Zoom. And my Friday morning classes are all purely on Zoom. So I teach, there's an advanced class at 9 and then there's a fitness class at 11:30 on a Friday, 11:30 to 1. We do kind of punch and kick in and stretching. It's quite good fun. Okay, 4, 3, 2, 1. So have a posture check. Relax, release your shoulders, and then we're just going to go forwards and back. So yeah, that's good.
The Bottisham one.
The Bottisham one. We didn't get enough people sign up for it. But actually, I don't really want to be teaching too many evening classes just because a lot of my teachers teach in the evening and I'd quite like to see them. So I'll probably, hopefully, be going to the Cambridge Academy of Martial Arts on a Tuesday instead, which should be very good. Yeah, I mean, in the old days, I used to teach 2 or 3 evenings a week, but then it meant I didn't get to it, and I prefer teaching during the day. So we're just going forwards and back, just show you that from the diagonal view. So I've got a little bit of a bounce thing going on, and I'm letting go in my shoulder joint. And also, because it's been a while, let's make sure all our joints are nicely warmed up. Okay, 4, 3, 2, 1, and wobbling. So we'll do a little joint warm-up thing. And I'd quite like to go through the Soong Gong deep relaxing exercises, just because they're great fun to do. has she? Just go and grab them. When we finish the warm up, then I'll try and find the music on my phone, and we'll have a little bit of music, because I don't want to use the one on there because I don't want to overload. It's a very old machine, and I'm surprised it's actually working. I'm never going to use. I won't say where I got the computer sorted, but I'm not going to use that again. It took too long. It was very nice, it took too long. So here we go, we're going to circle the shoulders first. We go up, back, down and round. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Other direction. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Other shoulders, so it's not left out. Here we go. We go backwards. 1, 2. There's a little bit of a waist turn. 3, 4, 5. That's it. Nice and relaxed. 6, 7 and 8. Other way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Nice. And then bird folds its wings. 1. Open the chest. Nice. 2. Open the back. Open the chest. 3, 4. Its wings. So the peng is a giant mythological bird, and one wing is supposed to cover half the planet. Okay. That's how big we all are. Okay, so you rotate in the shoulder, you turn the waist, you bring the arm forward, up, rotate the shoulder again around. So keep your arm relaxed. 4. Keep breathing. Cool, it's got really blustery. 5. What, do you know what's the... I didn't mention about it on the 6. Because it was lovely this morning. 7.
Rain before tea.
Rain before tea. 8. Okay. Nice and relaxed. Check your posture. And then here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. side. So I'll just show you that from the side view. This is a good one for lower backs. Connection is unstable. So, those of you on Zoom, if I suddenly switch off, just make it up yourselves. So my Burwell class, it's just the people in the room. There's no Zoom, but all my other classes have got a Zoom element, and some of them are just Zoom on their own. So, seven. Eight. Nice. Okay. And then just stretch up, turn, and over. One. Not too enthusiastic for this one, it's a bit of a stretch. Rotate the arm, two. Come back. One down, one up, rotate, three. One down, one up, rotate, four. One down, one up, rotate, five. One down, one up, rotate, six. Keep breathing, lovely. Seven. And eight. Fantastic. Really good. Okay, so. Breathing in and out. So what we'll do next is we're going to do Monkey King Take to Sea and Polishing the Table. And also, for fun, I think we should do Dragon Serves Teacups, just because the guys on Zoom can do it and it will be fun for everybody. I'm getting some... Oh, wow. Okay. It's... We're very lucky we're not in Wales. It's torrential rain and stormy over there. So thanks for the weather update. So yeah. So we've got nothing to complain about here, just a bit of wind.
It's headed our way.
Oh, is it heading our way? Ah, okay. So it's in Wales first, and it's coming over. Doom and gloom, brilliant. Yeah, it's happy new year over there. So what we're gonna do is you sink the hips back like that. And then you want to keep your chin tucked in, and then you come up, and then what happens is that hands counterbalance. And then when you come back up, you look very tall, and you want to sink your hips and relax. So you want to keep, when you come back to the upright position, you want to be nice and relaxed, rather than kind of, you want to be like this. And then that's better. It's called Monkey King Takes a Seat. So the Monkey King was one of the sort of legends in China, and there's lots of stories about him. And there was a TV show in the 70s.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Yes, yeah. And it, you know, and it's to do with that. So if that helps, but no flying on clouds. Okay, here we go. One, we'll just do six of these, and then you come back. That's it. Two, and then when you come up, you want to keep your knees in line with the toes. Three. So the knees are in line with the toes, that's it, and then four, five, and six, nice. So with a Monkey King, that one, you can, if you want, you can actually squat right down and come back up, if you're feeling exuberant. Or you can just do it there, and that's just as good. That will still give your back a little workout. It will still work your leg muscles. It will still work your balance. But my teacher Eva, she likes to go down into a full squat and says, if you want, and then we all go, nah, it's all right. Yeah. You need to be able to get back up again.
Yeah.
Okay, the next one is polishing the table. I will demonstrate. So it's a nice round shape in the arms. You turn, you swing the arms and the hips swing in a different direction, and then you put it back where you found it. Then you turn, swing, put it back where you found it. I'll show you from the side. Turn, swing, and back. Turn, swing, and back. Oh, we're doing it already. Okay, three. Join in if you haven't already. Four. We'll do eight of these. Five. Yeah, watch out for your friends. No, no. Six. Seven. And eight. Fantastic. Great. Shake out. Good. Yeah. Okay, let's do the knees, and then we'll do dragon serves teacup. So you bring your feet together. Now, they don't have to be fully touching. They can be out a bit if your knees don't like it. Put your hands on your knees. Just rest them gently with circle in one direction. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Other way. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. A little bit further apart, and then we go in and out. One, two, three, four, and five. And then we go the other direction. One, two, three, four, five. And then what we do some knee tapping. So we go on the inside. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Then on the top. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Then on the side. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And then like this. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Brilliant. We come back upright again. And then what we do is we do a little kick. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and ten. So that kicky one I got from Barry, this one I got off the interweb, and it's really good. It just because I was having some knee, I was noticing in Christmas I was getting some knee aching, and then doing those and then doing all the tapping, it seems to have, I think because of the extra circulation going round or something, it's been quite beneficial. So,
doesn't do your knee replacement.
Yeah, but be very careful. Be very careful. Just tap. You don't have to, you know, you're not like,
thumping.
No thumping, but a gentle tapping that will still help with the circulation. But if you've got a new knee and it's grumbling, then listen to what your new knee is telling you and just do very gentle tapping. And yeah, anything that's going to improve the circulation around that joint is probably a good thing, you know. So take a slightly wider step. We're just going to transfer the weight. There we go. Right. So I've been given a horrendous new exercise to do, but I'm not going to. You don't need to do it. It's horrible, but I'll show it to you if you want to laugh. I'll show it later. So, okay, what we're going to do now, for fun, is Dragon Serves Teacups demonstration. One, two. This is really good for the brain. Three, four, five. One, two, three, four, five. We're going to do that 10 times for fun, my fun. Okay, here we go. So, right hand first, and just do something. Just do something in a relaxed manner. Just do a thing and enjoy whatever it is you're doing, and then eventually you'll be able to do it. We just, you know, it's the thing, it gives your brain something to do in case you don't want your brain to get bored. So you give it something exciting to do. There we are. Right side first, and I'll do the counting. It won't help, but I'll do it. Ready, go. One, two, three, four, five. Left side, two, two, three, four, five. Left, right side, seven, two, three, four, five. Left, eight, two, three, four, five. Forwards, time, one, two, three, four, five. Last one, ten, two, three, four, five. And don't spill the tea. So, what you do is, if you want to, you can practice it with an actual bowl or cup of tea. So, the teacup, I won't fill it with water. So we've got a kitchen here.
Oh.
Semi-circle to the corners with your nose. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Fantastic. Okay, nice and relaxed. Just shake your hands. And then wiggle the fingers. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Lovely. And one, wrists. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. Other way. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Up, down. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and shake. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Circled elbows. One, two, three, four. Nice and tall through the spine. Seven, eight. Other way. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And then the big one. I like this one. One, two. Joys of spring. Three, wonderful. Four, five, six, seven. That's why you need to be away from each other. Eight, and then the other way. One, two, three, lovely. Four, oh, that's so nice. Five, six, seven, and eight. And then rolling forwards. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Rolling back. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Over and under. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And shake. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and ten. Okay, nice. So that was a bit of an extended warm up due to the, you know, being the new year, we're all a bit stiff.
Full of mince pies.
Too many mince pies. Yeah, I don't want to look another mince pie.
hide the face, at least not until October. But anyway, let's have a look at the basic silk reading, and then what I'd like to do is spend the rest of the class re-looking at the Fa Soong Gong, just because it's so good for relaxing and also for balance. But let's, so we're going to horse stance. Now you don't have to go as big as me. Then again, you don't have to go as small as me either, if you want to do a proper, no, it's fine. And then what we'll do is get your right hand, so put your left hand here, and then your right hand there, and you put your weight 60-40. Then you turn the waist, it comes down. You transfer the weight, it scoops under. You make a round shape in the arm. You turn the waist. And now when you turn the waist, make sure that this knee is still pointing where the toes point. So you want to rotate outwards in the hip joint and rotate out with the knee so that it's still... Then you get a stretch along here and then you release the stretch. So that's silk reading number one. So over the Christmas break, I was watching Chen Xiao Wang, Grandmaster Chen Xiao Wang, and when he does it, it looks amazing. But breathing in and out. Relax the shoulders. Lovely. Very nice. That was so good. We're going to do it with the other arm. So, here we go. Go down, goes down. One, two, three. Turn the waist. Watch out for your knees. Four. One, two, three, four. Nice. Circle. Smooth. Connected.
So your knees stay bent all the way through.
The knees stay bent all the way through, and also pointing where the toes are pointing all the way through. So it's quite tricky, really. So Grandmaster Chen Xiao Wang's video, he just basically does this exercise. He does it, shows it for an hour. We're not going to do it for an hour. So now we do it this side. Other side. One. Two. Transfer the weight. Three. Bring it down. Open the shoulder. Four. Transfer the weight. One. Two. Three. Four. One. Two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. Nice. Okay, and then we'll do one more in this with this arm. And just relax the arm, have a little bit of a shake out. And we'll do the other side. So the hand could go here, it can also go there and monitor the opening and closing of the hip joint. But at the moment we're just feeling the centre turning, and it's quite useful. So open the palms. Open the palms, so you've got this lovely open feeling in the hands, this alive feeling in the fingers. Keep breathing some more.
two more, and then seamlessly we do silk reeling number one at the same time, and we do this. Sink down. Keep breathing. So it makes its own rhythm, actually. Okay, two more circles. One more circle. And then when we get to the top quarter, we change directions. Ooh. Sink the hips nice and tall through the head. Breathing nice. Bless you. So. So yeah, we'll just keep going. I think I will have a bit of time off over the Easter break, but we run through half terms. And if any of you are on grandchild duty and need to bring a small person with you, feel free. There's no extra charge for small people. Just if you, the only thing is you have to be responsible for them not kicking off. So, and last, but it's...
My youngest grandchild is 26.
you can bring your grandchildren. They can pay for themselves. They'd be very welcome to come, whatever age your grandchildren are. But in half terms, because a lot of, well, maybe the great-grandchildren when they come up. But when... to look after the grandchildren. I said, well, bring them over. You know. Just while I'm here and there's new people, on Monday mornings in yonder village, at Swaffham Prior Village Hall, on Mondays at 10:30, I have Tai Chi and tea. So we do Chen style, and then we stop for a tea break. And there's biscuits as well, and hot chocolate and all sorts. And then we go and do a little bit more Tai Chi after. And that's an hour and a half. So we get about an hour and a quarter's Tai Chi, and then we also get a tea break, and it's all included. So if you fancy extra Tai Chi, and it's quite fun Tai Chi and tea, just because we...
I do like my granddaughter.
Yes.
She's only two.
Two's fine, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Really?
The youngest we've had was about three, and we've had babies watching, and they seem to quite like Tai Chi, small people. So yeah. Okay, let's should we do that one? Yeah, why not? Let's have a look at the middle winding. So setting one. So it's like this. One, then you come round, two, and then see, this is one I'm still working on myself, which is why I'm teaching it, because then maybe I'll have worked it out, but it's quite a good one for the brain. It's quite nice, it's like a kind of slappy thing, and then you go boom, like that, and you come in, and there's a new song and they go, this is how the chorus goes. Let's try it the other way.
Oh, no.
I know, it's horrible, isn't it? So this is middle winding, first setting.
You don't say
one's just a fling. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, right, we'll come back to that one.
Just
right, and then middle winding setting two. I know at least three different settings, but we're just doing two of them. You start here, and it goes like this, it goes like that, and it comes around. Oh, you'll love this. And then it goes three. One, two. So this is the one that Karel taught by using sound effects. So he goes like this, and he goes like this, and then he goes whoosh, and it worked. One, two, and then whoosh. See, worked brilliantly well. So the moral to the story, I'll turn round. The moral to the story is just be relaxed. So I'm not going to get really upset if you can't get this really difficult move straight away. Because, no, just keep breathing and just enjoy whatever it is. And relax. So just do something. And
well, I'm doing something.
There we go. No problem. And eventually,
it will use it to it a little bit.
Well, all the music, sorry. So let's have a look at the fa soong gong. So I've just got my little trick sheet here. We'll look at the first six. Okay. So, balancing yin and yang. So you're in Wu Qi stance and you just transfer the weight. Transfer the weight. So nice and tall through the spine, super hips, relax the shoulders. Time each side. Okay, and then turning the wheel. So we'll do it without the weight moving. You come up, you come forward, down, and back. Then the other hand comes up, forward, down, and back. Up, forward, down, and back. Up, forward, down. Forward, down, back. And then transfer the weight. Breathe in.
That's it. And then raise the hip. Raise the hip. Raise the hip. Feel it on the side. So this is circling, turning the wheel. Right, the next one's a bit tricky. One and two. Come back to the middle. It's called circling the wrists. So you come a little bit closer for the zoomies. Circle that way and then you relax. So it's a nice one for the shoulders. So you really want to let go in that shoulder joint and think about the connection through the whole of the arm. That's not bad. And then you transfer the weight. You come back, transfer the weight. So, yeah, when I did this on Monday, I got the order a bit. I put the sixth movement in instead of the fourth movement. So I'll rectify that now. Just shift the weight. So the book says you're supposed to do each one for 2 to 3 minutes an exercise, but we haven't got that, so we'll just... Now you raise the heel, come down, 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 raise the heel. One more time each side. Okay, the next one's called palm press. It's called palm press. So you come up like that. Turn, you come up, you turn. So it's like a ball. If you've got a squidgy ball, you squidge, you turn, and then you come up. So about shoulder height and leg height. And then you come back. Just got to try and work out which way that... Oh, it's that way, I see. Yeah, that's it. It's the opposite way that you think. Which makes a lot more sense when you raise the heel, actually. So this is the one we left out. And then try lifting. So then it makes sense that you lift the heel, and that's the hand that lifts. Lift the heel. One more time each side. Nice, come back to the middle. And then we've got parting the waves. So you start here like this, and we're just doing transfer of the weight. Then you come back to the middle, the hands swap round, and you part the waves. You come back to the middle, the hands swap round, and you part the waves. Okay, the final one is called marching, and what you do with this one, I'll show you, is you come up in a curve, and then you turn the palm and stroke down with your fingers. And you do it with the other hand, come up in a curve, up and down. Up and down. Up and down. Actually, we won't do the lift, the heel lift yet. We'll just do it like this. Show from the diagonal. Up, down. And then actually, this is the last movement. One more time. turn starts. Single, right crane spread a twig. So right hand, left hand. Then step, diagonal posture, sweep down with the left hand. So the left foot's forward, raise the knee. And then this is the stepping. One, two, three, diagonal posture. And step three times. One, two, three. This time, step out. Make a fist with the right hand. Punch with the right hand. Turn, turn. Turn to the front. Turn into the left leg. Release the right leg. Release the right leg. And then guardian warrior, hands in the water. And then close. So that's what we're working on. Oh gosh, it's nearly half past. Sorry about that. Come round into a circle, but just so you can see where we're kind of aiming to get to. Well done, Zoomies. That was good. So, sink the hips. So we just go back to what we did right at the beginning, which was just getting the arm. So we want to swing, and although the arms are relaxed, you're connecting to the whole of the body, and you're sinking your hips back and down. It's quite nice with the music on, isn't it? So I will get in touch with Peter and see if we can do our rhythm and moves weekend, so that it's sort of all day Saturday, Friday evening, and most of Sunday, a whole weekend of me doing very simple exercises, and Peter and playing lovely piano, and then me joining in every now and then. So it's kind of music, moving, music and moving. It's called rhythm and moves. And it's just good fun. Keep breathing. Okay. Embrace the tiger, turn to the mountains. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. One more time. That's it. And then if you've got glasses on, tend to put them there like that, then I won't lose them. Rub the hands together and polishing the face. And then rub the hands together and give the lower back the rub. It's
nice.
It's nice. Yeah, it's the best bit. Nice and relaxed. And then breathe in. Breathe out. And we'll do two more. Nice and tall, just nice and relaxed, just feel the ground under the feet. Take a couple of slow, deep breaths.